Today we're with Kim Crosby, who is now starring in the new Advent Calendar musical, Kris Kringle the Musical. Kim, welcome. How did you get started?
Well, I'll back up a little bit. I moved to New York in my early 20s, and my first Broadway show was Jerry's Girls, which was
Gary Herman musical
review. Yeah, and it was a lot of fun, just a lovely bit of fluff, and I had a marvelous time. It was being my first show in New York. I had a wonderful time. But then I was in the original company of Into the Woods. I played.
Right. And you were wonderful. Seriously wonderful.
Well, thank you. And I'm so grateful all these years later, especially that we had the great performances, the PBS great performances recording of that, because that, you know, it lived on for a lot of people because of that. And so that was my big break, I suppose.
Can you lead us up to Kris Kringle, what you've done, so that people really get to know who you are?
Oh goodness. Well, I've had lived in and out of New York several times since my Broadway debut, since Jerry's Girls. As I said, next was Into the Woods, and then I got married to my prince, after all, Robert Westenberg. We are, in fact, celebrated our 30th anniversary this spring, we will. And anyway, have a couple of babies, lovely little girls, and then I went into the company of Guys and Dolls. After that, the Broadway revival from 95, and you know, as is often the case with a lot of actors, I certainly, you know, was in and out, especially being knocked up three times while I was trying to pursue a career. You know, not the easiest thing in the world to do, but I've had a varied career, to be sure. I've performed a lot with the Pops Symphony Orchestras, and and I did a lot of commercials, a lot of television commercials. Oh, hi, Kitty.
That's Hamlet.
I've had a very varied career, and Kris Kringle, it came to me 3 years ago. I was invited to be a part of the cast when we had the performance at Town Hall in New York City, and it's just been a lovely association. I just adore the show, and was really delighted when Ben and Jamie Salke called me up to ask me if I'd like to be a part of this virtual production, having never done anything like this, and certainly being very, very challenged with respect to this type of production. It was very challenging, and I have to say, Ben and Jamie are the most patient people in the world, because they really had to have a lot of patience, you know, especially with my challenges from the technical standpoint. But I'm really fascinated to see it all come together. I think that the Advent viewings that you're able to have every day are just delightful. And I love seeing everybody's work.
Yeah. I think it's magical. I think that this is such a wonderful idea. I've always been a big fan of Advent calendars, where you get to open it up and see the little picture or get the piece of chocolate.
Yeah, so yeah, a little bit of magic to help you be patient for the holidays, I suppose.
But I think it's fabulous. I love this idea. I think it's, in this time where we could use a lot of magic, this is a perfect gift to both the Broadway and the theater community, but also to others that need this desperately.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. And especially during this time, you know, as you said, it's you have to get creative to be able to bring people together like this, even from all over the states, and from widely varied abilities and settings, and to see it all come together has really been fascinating. It's been quite an accomplishment, to say the least. So I really look forward to seeing. I've been enjoying it every day, and just so proud to be a part of such a wonderful company.
Everybody's now, there. Have your kids seen it?
No, they have not. I have a daughter who lives with her husband in Denver. I think they'll be tuning in on Christmas Day, and we'll certainly all sit down to watch on Christmas Day.
Oh,
yeah, they just want. They're as excited to see the result of all those weeks, the days and weeks that I was upstairs standing in front of my my blue backdrop and just to see it all come together. I think it's pretty fascinating.
What have you done during this time to keep yourself positive and to keep yourself in the loop, so to say?
Well, I think communicating frequently with the people that we love, you know, checking in on them, letting people know that you're thinking of them is restorative, because it gives you hope that things will one day be back to normal, and we'll all be forever changed by this, of course. You know, I think that it certainly helps you know what you value and the people that you value, and certainly never to take that freedom for granted ever again. But I admire people's wherewithal and their creativity, and we'll all get through this together if we just have to hang in there a little bit longer. You know, God willing, you know, the spring will be a bright time, and it'll be a time of renewal in a lot of ways.
Absolutely. Can you tell us a little bit about your role in Kris Kringle?
Well, I play Mrs. Claus. I play right. Mrs. Claus. And that's in my career, of course. I grew up, throughout my, my teenage years and in college and professionally, I've always played the ingenue. So, and of course, in my mind, Mrs. Claus was always the gray-haired old lady with glasses, and but she's a kindly soul, and I like her. She's spunky in this production. She's a great foil for her husband, and has a kind heart, and is generous, but nobody's fool, obviously. And she's given some lovely music to sing, so I'm really, really grateful for that. But it's a lovely new take and reimagining of that role, and I've really, really enjoyed it.
What roles would you like to take on that you haven't had a chance to take on yet?
Oh gosh, I've not lived in New York for many years, so I just played Dolly last year, and that's not a role that I ever had anticipated playing, but I had a marvelous time doing it. I grew up performing at Springfield Little Theater here in Springfield, Missouri, which is where I live. And my husband, Robert, he teaches at Missouri State University. He's the coordinator for the BFA musical theater program there. Does a marvelous job. He's a wonderful teacher. So every once in a while they will get an equity contract for me to perform on the stage where I grew up performing. So Dolly, even though it was the last show that little theater was able to have live on stage before everything started to shut down. So I have to say that's certainly been a surprise in my career to have played that role, but I really delighted in all of it. I suppose, well, I can think of several roles that I hadn't been able to play, in my career, just for whatever reason, the opportunity, it never came up. I think Mame would be a fun role, now that I've aged into playing, to the great Dame roles, I think Mame would be marvelous to experience at least once.
You'd be doing a roundabout of Jerry Herman.
I guess so.
What is your Christmas wish for the world?
Oh goodness, it's a wish that I think everybody wishes for goodness and common sense to prevail, for the intelligence in our leaders. I always wish, that we all have patience and acceptance of each other, and, always hope in myself, of course, to be generous and thoughtful and respectful, it's a tough world, and it's especially challenging right now, but I really hope that, naturally hope for an end to the pandemic very, very soon, but let's cool the temperature and let common sense and love prevail would be my wish.
They say that eyes are the windows to the soul, but I think that songs are. If you had to choose a song or cycle of songs to describe who you are, what would that be?
Oh my. A cockeyed optimist, I would say, describes me pretty well. I'm a sucker for any I want song and any musical that I've ever seen. I weep at the overture whenever I'm at a musical.
Me too.
it's just so stirring and so hopeful.
I agree.
I think that any song that has anything to do with hopefulness. That's a good question. I have to think about that. Cockeyed optimist comes to mind first and foremost.
I always want people to know the people that I'm interviewing. And I think that by getting into the heart and soul of them, you find out more and you learn more. And therefore you become invested. Last question, is there anything that I haven't asked you that you would like our readers to know about?
Oh goodness. About the show itself.
About you, about life. This is your say what you want.
Well, I feel very blessed. I'll say that much. And as I said before, I think what do I hope for the future and for the new year? I think that I've had a rough family wise. I've had several losses in my family and within the last several years, and as everybody does, I think in light of loss and especially the trials that everyone around the world have been going through lately, looking forward. I think that we just need to see the best in each other, and appreciate anew what we have and what we should value, because everybody's blessed. Every day that we have on this earth is a blessing.
Thank you so much. You have been listening to our interview with Kim Crosby from Kris Kringle, the musical that you can turn into nightly. Just go to T2C. We have it up there every day on What to Watch. Thank you, Kim, very, very much.
You're welcome. It's a pleasure.